everybody saw, and if you missed it in the email, put a note in there about we hope to have our new assistant basketball coaches, Justin Ganey and Ron Clark, available sometime next week, hopefully Coach Barnes as well. But wait till spring football wraps up before we get to those guys. And with that, we'll go ahead and jump into questions for John Fulkerson. And let's start with Mike Wilson.
Wait, Tom.
And Gustavo.
Tom.
Yes, sir.
The script I wrote down, I left it behind here, and it's blank today.
Oh, you're just going to have to wing it.
All right, I'll wing it.
Go ahead, Mike.
We'll go off script to start then, John. You good?
Yes.
All right, cool. John, if your season hadn't ended the way it had, do you think that you would have ultimately made the decision to come back to Tennessee?
I think so. I think that I would now be considering other options. I think that was really a big key factor that played into my decision-making to come back to Tennessee. And I think that really it was God showing me that I had the opportunity and chance to do it one more time.
So, Keith, you mentioned, just to do it one more time, and what went through your mind when you made that decision, you know, up until about you post that video on Friday, what went through your mind, the process to make that decision?
There was a lot that was going through my head, and really, I was just weighing out my options to see what the best decision was for me, and just making sure that I was going to make the right decision for myself. And after a lot of prayer and consideration and talking with my parents and talking with some mentors and people I really look up to, I decided to come back. And it wasn't really all about for me personally, but really for me to help this team that we're going to have next year and to mentor some of the guys coming in. And I really think this team is going to be special and we can really accomplish something.
Go ahead, Rick Russo.
Hey, John. Good morning. Following up a little bit on what you just said, number one, how instrumental was your family, especially your mom and dad, in making this decision? And as a veteran player, obviously you're going to give it all. You're all as an athlete. But do you see yourself maybe, too, as a player coach out there coming up next season?
My parents were so supportive in this decision, as they have been my whole life. And they were giving me some great guidance, some great tips and advice, but ultimately they did not want me to do this or do that. They just wanted me to do what I wanted to do, and they were going to support me either way. And I think that's what the best parents do. They let you make your own decision, especially at my age, and they were going to support me either way. They were going to love me either way. And so really credit to them for supporting me and helping me through all of that. And then I do see myself as a player coach, because I've played for Coach Barnes for a while now, and I think that I know what he's wanting and know kind of the system. And I think that it's great to have a voice out there that can help the guys.
Let's go David Pascal, Brown Lewis, and Mike Wilson.
A question and a quick follow, if I could. When you consider the tears that you showed on senior day, the injury that you sustained in the SEC tournament, and then not being able to play in the NCAA tournament, that's a two-week stretch that was a lot to inhale. How did you kind of decompress from all that, knowing that you still had this decision to make?
You're right. That was a busy and jam-packed about 2 weeks. And so really after the season, once we got back, I went home for about a week and just kind of decompressed, like you said, and hung out with my family. I wasn't able to play basketball still, and so I was just hanging out with my family and chilling and spending time with them. And that's when I really had the opportunity to think about what I wanted my next steps to look like, and just what I wanted my future to look like as well.
And as the quick follow, just kind of how are you doing now? If somebody asks, hey, John, let's play a pickup game after lunch, could you play?
Of course, I would love to. We started spring practice maybe this is our fourth week. And so I've been going for 4 weeks now, and I feel fine. Everything is great. And I'm so excited to get back here in the summer with my new teammates.
John, speaking of new teammates, you've got a lot of them all of a sudden. And how much did the way that Coach Barnes was able to remake the roster, specifically give you a lot of help in the paint last week, impact your decision? Or did it? Were you coming back no matter what? Or did that kind of invigorate you when you saw that you weren't going to have to deal with double teams every time down and get beat up like you did last year?
I pretty much had my decision made before he started getting all those recruits. But when he was getting all those recruits, it really made me want to let you guys know and let this next team know that I was going to be on the team and I was going to do whatever I could do to help this team, and just how excited I was to play on this team. So I had my decision made up, but once we started getting all those recruits, it made me just so much more excited to let them know.
John, when did you make that final decision? And you talked about that week at home. What kind of, I guess, research or exploration did you do into potential other options other than returning to Tennessee?
The decision came just the more I thought about it, the more I thought about the way I ended here at Tennessee. And I was talking to Bob Kessling last night, and I told him just my love for this university, and when I put on a Tennessee jersey for this community, for the city of Knoxville, I just didn't want to end it the way I did. And especially if I had the chance to do it again and finish on my terms, then I would love to do that, and I would love to go out how I want to go out. And so the more I thought about that, the more it got me excited to have the ability to return. And so during that week, I just talked with my parents and some mentors of mine and kind of entertained the fact that I potentially could come back. And after lots of talking and consideration, I decided to.
Jimmy Himes and Jordan Kramer.
John, the CBS preseason poll at Tennessee 25th, and then it jumped to number 15 when you decided to come back. That's a pretty nice compliment, isn't it?
I thought we should have been ranked number one. I'm just kidding. Honestly, I didn't see that. I probably won't see it. I don't really look at preseason rankings or rankings in general, but I guess thank you. I guess that's a good compliment. But like I said, I don't really look at the preseason rankings or rankings in general.
And I don't know if you feel comfortable with this, and I know you're the kind of guy that doesn't want to make excuses. Did you have COVID, and did that affect your play this past season?
I did have COVID, and I think that COVID affected a lot more than my play. I think that COVID affected a lot of people and a lot of different programs, and I think I can go as far as having the fans in the arena affected a lot of different programs, a lot of different people, players. And I think, honestly, one of the things for me is I think you guys know how much of an energy player I am and how much I love the fans. And I really like playing off the fans and their energy. And with them not being there, every team in this country had to create their own energy. And so I think not only for me, but for every team out there, COVID affected them, whether they had it or not, personally, their stamina, their conditioning, the energy, things like that. So I think COVID all around affected this whole program. And that's what makes me so excited for next year, is for it to be somewhat of a more normal year. And have, well, I heard Mr. Danny White talk about last night that he wants Neyland packed full, and so I hope he can say the same about Thompson Bowling Arena, and so that makes me just so excited about next year and seeing what we can do.
Hey, John, when the NCAA first presented this added year of eligibility, were you leaning one way or another, staying or going back then? And how much did it weigh on you throughout the season, kind of the impending decision that you would have to make?
Right. Whenever this, I guess, rule or eligibility rule came out about staying one more year and this year not counting, I was actually in quarantine. And Coach Barnes called me and one of our assistants and was like, are you coming back? And I said, no, you know, like I've been here long enough. This is going to be a great year. And I did not think for a single second that I would come back or that I was going to return. But then just at the end of the season with all of the factors that played in, I guess that was a complete change of events.
Luis Fernandez, want to take more questions?
John, you mentioned the conversation you had with your family about this decision and also talking to a lot of mentors. Who were some of those mentors that you spoke with and what was the feedback that you got from them during this process?
Some of my mentors, really my biggest one other than my parents would be my AAU coach, and he's really like my second dad. And I played for him for 4 years, and now since I quit playing for him and I've been in Tennessee, our relationship has just grown over the years and we've become closer. We go out to eat all the time. I'm going to his practices, he's coming to the games, things like that. And really with everyone I talked to, they were about like my parents. They did not tell me a decision to make. They gave me the pros and cons of each decision. They supported me, whichever one I was going to pick, and they just wanted me to do what made me the happiest and what I wanted to do.
Mike Wilson, Rob Lewis, and Gestapo.
John, with next year's team, what are the attributes or changes, I guess, from last year to next year that excite you most about the potential of that team?
I think that, I don't know if this is really what you're looking for, but I think the biggest thing I'm excited for about this team is our team chemistry and team bonding opportunities, just because I feel like last year COVID really inhibited us for really hanging out as a team and creating our team chemistry and team bonding experiences. And because I think hanging out off the court and things such as team meals, movies, events, things like that help you just as much off the court about getting to know each other as it does on the court. And so that's something that makes me excited about this team. And I've talked to a lot of the players coming in and they're all in and they're so excited to get here to work. And so I'm just excited for them to get here and for us to, I guess, come together as one team.
And a quick follow-up on that, are you going to be required to live on campus for a sixth year?
Excuse me?
Are you going to be required to still live on campus despite it being your sixth year here in Tennessee?
Yes, they're making me live on campus. They said I'm the only one that does, and then freshman, sophomore, junior, senior, fifth years don't, only 6 years have to live on campus. Actually, no, this will be the first time in 7 years that I haven't lived in a dorm. So I'm excited about that because I lived in the dorm in high school for 2 years and then 5 years at Tennessee. So that's another thing I'm very excited about, is not living in a dorm.
John, just what's the vibe have been like when you're in the gym for workouts with so many, you know, guys gone? Are there six of you now?
I think
in back, and just, you know, what's the feeling like with so much roster turnover?
We are missing a lot, you're right. And but our walk-ons are there as well. And so I think with everybody, I think we've got nine maybe. And So we've been doing the most we can and the best we can and really competing and getting better. And but yesterday we had some VFLs in the gym. I'm not sure if I'm allowed to mention their names, but we had some former players in the gym, and they really competed with us too, and it was great to see them as well. But it's definitely been different with not having a full team there, really, like you said, just half a team. But we've been still getting our work in and competing and getting better.
And just quick thoughts on the two new coaches. I mean, in addition to the roster, you kind of had a coaching staff flip too. What do you think about Coach Gainey, Coach Clark, how they kind of integrated themselves into things?
First of all, I already do miss Coach English and Coach Oliver. I think I'll be seeing Coach Oliver a little bit. I think I'm going to take him to Pals when I get home. I hope he's been already. And then Coach English, I've talked to him probably at least 5, 6, 7 times since he's left. And so we're still building our relationship and keeping it very fine-tuned and in touch a lot. And so I'm going to miss them a lot because they brought so much to our program. But I really like, we call him RC. Coach Rod Clark does not want to be called Coach Clark. So I call him RC. We call him RC. And I really like him. He kind of reminds me of Coach English. He's a younger coach and really knows the game, really knows how to help us. And then Coach Gainey, he's very active, and he's going to be a great addition to our program as well. And so I'm really excited to get to know those guys, and I think they're going to help our team a ton.
Fulky, after you made your decision on Friday, you had quite a bit of a busy weekend. You drove the first pitch on Saturday. You went to the baseball game. How was that weekend, you know, the atmosphere, especially on that baseball game and during the first pitch?
Yes, you're right. It has been a crazy weekend, but it was a fun weekend. And man, our baseball team, I could talk for a long time about them. I told their coach last night that I'm one of their biggest fans, and I just love the way that his team plays. They play with so much heart and competitiveness and togetherness and energy, and I really enjoy watching them play, and it was so fun to throw that first pitch, just because I wanted to really get everybody hyped for them and really get them going, and I really did not want the spotlight to be on me. So it was so fun. I was there when Evan Russell hit that grand slam, and man, that place went crazy. And that weekend was so fun. And then we as a team went on Sunday to the baseball game, and we're hanging out as a team. And I think it's great to see other student athletes at Tennessee support your teammates and the other people on other teams. And it just shows that everybody is for Tennessee and supports one another. And it was just a really fun experience.
Jimmy Hearns?
John, when you're engaged in those practice games, are you wearing some type of a protective mask?
No.
Okay. Also, from personally, what do you feel like you have to do to be more consistent this year compared to last year?
I think that I think it starts in practice and my everyday work. I think that a lot of it's on the mental side and just getting mentally prepared that you've got to play your best and work your hardest every single day, because teams are going to continually get better and individuals are going to continually to get better. So I think that you've got to approach it to where that you've got to tell yourself you've got to continue to get better.
We'll take one last call for questions. All right, John, appreciate it.